There's something evil here, and there's more than one. We don't know.
Did you hear that?
Yeah.
A shadow came up very quickly behind me.
Hey, look at that. It's look what's going on.
It's holy water. Like I said, I keep seeing something manifest over there. Keep going in and out, in and out. It did give me a lot of F words.
Yeah.
And then it told me to die. It told me to die.
And I got to right there where the stairs are. There was a guy sitting on the stairs.
That's it then.
I knew you were going to say that.
It did.
Oh!
It said it did. We're finally live tonight. It's Mystic Ghost. I'm Michelle DePaul. We have Ben Hogan with us, Allison Tidwell,
hi,
and Father Reuben. And you're in my way.
No, you're okay. You can stand right there. Don't worry.
Okay.
This is it's a wide angle.
So before we get started, I just wanted to say a couple things. I want to thank Ben for all his hard work getting this whole live stream up and going. And you know, again, this is a new platform that we're using, and he's just doing an incredible job. So thank you, Ben, for doing this.
Yeah,
he'll invoice us later.
Expecting my money.
And I'll
just kidding.
I'll pay you in gummy bears.
Yeah.
All right. So I also wanted to thank Allison for all her hard work. You know, she comes out, she's our psychic medium, and, you know, she's able to tune into the different entities at different locations that we're at, and she's able to give us validation. So I know it can be very taxing on your body sometimes, but Allison, thank you so much.
Thank you.
And then lastly, I know you guys have noticed Father Reuben's been joining us on some investigations, but I wanted to formally welcome him to the Mystic Ghost family. So we have Father Reuben with us again tonight to keep us safe, and we appreciate everything that you do and all the help that you do for folks that reach out to you. Mm-hmm. So we're very appreciative of that. So with that being said, we're back at the Corsicana Parks Lane Bowling Alley, where we were out here roughly 5-6 months ago.
September,
yeah, the beginning.
2021.
I wasn't.
Allison wasn't with us, and they're actually having activity again. So we're back out here. We're with a smaller group this time. I'm hoping to try different things to see if we can really find out what's still hanging around this building. Most of all, thank you for the folks that, you know, jump on our live stream. We appreciate all your support, so thank you. Thank you so much for that. So tonight, we have Lacey, and you can come on over here. Lacey is an employee here, and we're going to be interviewing her, and she's going to kind of take us around and let us know some of the things that she's been experiencing at the bowling alley. So if you want to step away, Allison, so you don't hear any...
See y'all later.
Yeah, Allison's going to step outside so she doesn't hear what's going on.
So the first thing that ever happened before I even started working here, I was up here. My husband works in the kitchen, and I was just leaning here talking to him, and I felt someone put their hand in my pocket and grab my bottom. And I spun around real quick because I was going to punch whoever did it, but no one was there.
I can definitely relate to what Lacey just said. The first time that we went out to the bowling alley, right in the beginning, something kept trying to attack me. And throughout the night, I mean, this was ongoing. So Father Reuben had to perform a prayer of protection at the end of the night just to make sure nothing was going to follow me home or be attached to me.
In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, be gone, thou unclean spirit. They're gone against this child of God. Be gone now.
But right when I got behind lanes 4 and 5, I saw a shadow come up behind me. I spun around thinking it was one of the guys because I saw the shadow run up onto my shadow. I spun around. There, of course, no one was there, but I felt an instant, almost like wind blew over me, but it was an energy. And I could tell that it did not want me back there. That's probably the biggest thing, because I mean, the hair stood up on the back of my neck, there were some goosebumps down my body, I knew something was with me. And then that back corner, the very top of the corner, I was sitting on top of 7, waiting, watching the machine, making sure it was working, and I could see something crouched in that corner. So when I got to, about right here. So normally that top corner light is on, so it casts a shadow this way. As I was walking, I could see my own shadow, and a shadow came up very quickly behind me. I thought it was one of the guys, so I spun around, thankful that someone was back here, and nothing was there. And as you can see the numbers clearly from here, there was something standing in front of the number, not letters, the number, and I couldn't see it. I could not see
through it. So there was like a shadow figure?
Yes, it was a solid black figure standing in front of the 16, to where I couldn't even see the number anymore. I was having kind of a hard time breathing.
Here?
And yeah, here, only since y'all got here. It's almost like I kept hearing a voice in my head, and it was, why do you want me gone?
It's weird, the more she keeps talking, like I feel sick to my stomach, my throat's getting all, you hear me clearing my throat, because I feel like I'm getting choked up in my throat.
That's how I've been since y'all walked in, but I've been having to catch my breath, having to coax myself to breathe, and very shaky.
That's just, that right there, normal, that's a spiritual interference with your... body functions.
After hearing Lacey say that she was having thoughts that weren't her own, Father Reuben felt it was best to do a prayer for her before she left the building.
Do you give me permission to enter your life through God, Christ, and the Holy Spirit?
Yes, I do.
Okay. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I anoint thee, and I protect you, and we bless you. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Nobody but the Sefilile, et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Yeah.
We're gonna now have Allison to come in here. She's, as I said, as a medium, so she's gonna go ahead and see what's around her after the member of the staff for this bowling center. Now we're going to have someone to see whatever is here. And so the recap is that there's something evil here, and there's more than one. We don't know.
While we're waiting for Allison, Ben's going to do a test run. We're going to try and go back out there again. If it gets cut out, just bear with us. We're going to jump back on the live stream.
Let's just walk back there.
Smoke, like someone just blew a cigarette.
Yeah, I forget. What did she say?
Allison.
What did Allison say?
Allison said,
she's back.
I could hear.
Oh. Yeah.
All right, this is what we're gonna do. Let me turn this down. Allison can, she can't go back there because we're gonna lose signal. She can explain where she was picking up on stuff. Let's go to the pool table and do a session there.
Mm-hmm.
And let's just try and draw whatever is back there out
okay.
to us.
Yeah.
Okay, when I first got here tonight, one of the main places I was automatically drawn to was that door back there. And when I walked in there, I picked up on a little girl. And I could actually hear her with my own ears humming. And so I decided to raise the vibrations a bit with the... you know how I normally do it.
Mm-hmm.
And I began walking down the hallway, and then I got to right there where the stairs are between 8 and 9 in that middle section.
Yeah.
And there was a guy sitting on the stairs. And when I turned and looked at him, it was almost like he was fixing to jump out at me. Like he's, you know, gonna be mischievous and jump out and try to scare me, but I just turned and looked at him like that, and I kind of caught him off guard.
Is he good, bad?
Right now, I feel like he's very mischievous, almost kind of like a sociopath type thing. Like, you know, he'll do something to you and try to play tricks on you. He thinks it's funny, but it's actually very off-putting to those who feel it. There's something off about him.
Well, that's it then.
Yeah.
We'll go back to, we'll go over to the pool table, I guess.
Okay.
We're going to cut these lights out here pretty soon.
Okay.
We're going to begin by doing a few different types of spirit box sessions. We'll be using multiple devices, and hopefully we'll get some answers to our questions.
Y'all can talk. Say something.
Oh, I want to turn these lights off.
Yeah, how do we turn those? Oh, it's on the pole there, isn't it? The column? Oh, it's down there. Lights out.
You want me to put the cat somewhere else? Like down by the lane?
Yeah, you should. Well, you should put it. Because you know how she said.
Let me go.
Because you know how she said that the thing comes out of the door at 16 and goes across the lanes. So maybe put it down somewhere around, you know, near 16 or 15 at the end there, and see if it knocks it, makes it go out, go that way. Well, put it on the actual lane. Yeah.
It's gonna roll.
Well, there you go.
All right,
see?
Leave it there.
I gotta turn around. I can't see where I'm going.
I'd like to call upon any entities in this building to come forward. If you can hear my voice, I want you to come over to my voice. I'm going to be using a device that's going to allow you to use words to communicate with us. And I'll be using the S-Box. So this is our first time actually using this device. We normally use the SB7, which is this. We also use the Direct Link, which is one of my favorites. We have Allison's Poltercom. Am I seeing that right? Mm-hmm. He said it was
Polterpod, because it's a smaller version of the Poltercom.
Polterpod. And then because the trifield meter is pointing away from us, anybody watching, if you see this going off, if you can throw it in the chat, Allison will be checking the chat to let us know if that starts to give you any indication that there's spirits around us. So if there's any entities, you kind of get an idea of what we're doing. I'm going to turn on this device. You'll be able to pick up words and communicate with us. I really want to concentrate on a name first, so let us know who you are. What's your name? No, I don't have it on record, or do you want me to record the whole session? Alright, we're gonna just listen first. That's it then.
I knew you were gonna say that.
It did.
Oh!
It said it did. Did you hear that?
Oh,
holy
wow,
shit.
I heard that. That was
oh,
good.
And I didn't record it. That's it then.
I knew you were going to say that.
It did.
Oh!
It said it did. That's it then.
I knew you were going to say that.
It did.
Oh!
It said it did. Did you hear that?
Oh,
holy
wow,
shit.
I heard that. That was
oh,
good.
And I didn't record good. It.
Yeah, I was just about to tell you to I was like, you should just record. Why would
all right, I'm recording
that?
Now.
Like,
can you say that again? Did you say Ben? I've got to do burst because if I record and it's...
Yeah.
Tell us your name. Or say one of our names.
Playback.
It's towards the end.
I was going to say, Father, we've been doing it for damn weeks.
Ben.
Oh, come on.
Yes, it did.
Ben.
It did say Ben.
The first time I was going to
say Ben.
The second
it said
time.
Ben.
It said Ben. I heard it too.
I'm telling you.
Can we want a sign that you're here, you know? Like, give us a sign that you're here. Something. Do something. Kind of thing. You know what I mean?
Make a noise. Make that cat go off.
A knock.
TV come on. Bring me a box of candy.
Knock a bowling pin down. Okay, well, I just wanted to give you this comment real quick. Amanda Laverne said, I was tripped at lane 6 in the back. I thought Mike, my dad, and I were conversing to look up and realize he was gone and there was no one there.
Who tripped Amanda? Why are you still in this building? What is it?
I don't know. I don't know what that last thing was.
There's somebody behind me now. There's somebody behind me. Who's behind me?
Father Reuben, who's behind Father Reuben? Who's standing behind us? Somebody right behind us?
There's somebody behind me. Right behind me.
We had no idea that the spirit box said devil and Satan. Was this the man's spirit that Allison saw during her walkthrough? Was he just trying to scare us?
There was a guy sitting on the stairs.
Right now, I feel like he's very mischievous. Almost kind of like a sociopath type thing. Like, you know, he'll do something to you and try to play tricks on you. He thinks it's funny, but it's actually very off-putting to those who feel it.
Or was this something more demonic that we're dealing with?
There's something evil here, and there's more than one. We don't know.
Who's behind Father Reuben?
What was it?
Looks like it's looking over our shoulder.
Yeah, what we're doing. And that's what I'm feeling right now. Something behind me. It's behind me. Right behind me. Always getting strong. It seemed like something was on my leg, then it went this way and went around. It seemed like it's trying to hide, trying to play hide and seek.
Do you still feel it? Do you feel something?
Yeah, I can feel it. It's like It was right behind me, you know, just right in the center behind me, like not close, not touching me, but
yeah.
This far. About, you know, it was this, I could feel it.
Right.
So it's just like I said, it was there and then it's moving around. Then as soon as it came behind me, then it moved around my leg area. It doesn't want to be known. That's what I'm trying to say.
Oh, well, but it's right behind you, though.
Yeah, it was behind me.
And we're talking about it at this point.
Yeah, it was right behind me.
I'm going to walk down here towards the door. Wow, that's so dark. Did my light go out? Wow, it's just really dark. It's just so dark in here. So I might make that cat go off because it's motion sensor, and if I turn and the light hits it, it may send it off. But that's the cat over there. Huh. I just heard some noise over here. Felt like I heard, I mean, it's probably just creaking from the stuff here, but I could hear like creaking, like a creaking noise. I'm gonna be quiet for a second. I'm just gonna be quiet for a second and see if I can. That was me leaning on this, made that creak noise. Yeah, I can. What?
Could you please?
Yeah.
Trying to get this cat to go off, it won't go on.
Oh.
Hello?
Is that to test it?
Bye-bye. Hello? Bye-bye.
That's more creepy than it laughing, I think. I just can't get the motion sensor to work on it. I thought it doesn't laugh. Oh, there it goes. The damn thing. That's not creepy, is it?
Our next Spirit Box session will be using the Puck 2 by Digital Dowsing. The Puck 2 uses the environment, such as temperature, biometric pressure, humidity, light levels, magnetic field changes, and this allows spirits to use this data and pull words to communicate with us.
Take a minute, because it's...
Yeah, so let Father Reuben ask a question. You guys just go like in a circle.
Okay.
You know, ask a question.
Father Reuben?
Yeah. Are you summon here?
I just heard something over there.
Chills.
Chills?
Ooh. Did you hear what I said?
Yeah, mm-hmm. You said you got something.
I just... heard something
since I said that, well, you summoned here.
Yeah, you said you summoned here, she said I feel something, and then it said chills.
After reviewing our footage, we realized that we caught this strange light anomaly on lane 11 going towards the front of the bowling alley. We thought that this was maybe a reflection caused by the SLS camera, but after further analysis, it was determined that this was not caused by the SLS camera. Could this possibly be spirit energy? It was captured at the same time that I felt something, and at the same time the spirit box had said chills. Was this the entity that kept bothering Father Reuben?
Was summoned here.
Yeah, I said somebody said, were you summoned here?
Who's watching us? Somebody watching us?
Duty.
Like it's their duty to watch us, maybe?
I thought it meant like duty because we're standing in front of the bathroom.
All right, hold on a second. I call upon any entities in this building. Come over to my voice. Come over to the table. This is your chance to communicate with us. Tell us your name. Tell us why you're here. Make a noise. Just give us something.
Ooh.
Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm, I do.
Thank you. Can you make another noise? We got to know where you're at so we can, we'll either come over to you, but if you could come over to us, that would be great. Give us another sign, please. Why are you trying to show yourself to these folks while they're working? You know, you have a group here right now that wants to communicate with you. So now is your chance to communicate with us. Whoever's hiding in that back area, come out. We want to talk to you. We know you're back there.
How'd you walk back there? I'm going to go to the door.
Who's back here? I saw something. Sorry. Don't lose connection.
Nope.
Alright, who's back here? I'm back here. Remember me? I'm only going to take like 2 steps out of your view. Right there.
Yeah.
Right here.
Well, I might be able to see you.
Alright, do you remember me? I'm back. Oh, shit.
What?
As soon as I came, like, took those 2 steps, colors are popping up everywhere on the SLS. you've been watching the SLS, right? It's been pretty gray.
I mean,
like, no colors.
I've zoomed down it a couple of times.
Well, it's locked up. Yeah. As soon as I took two steps in, and I don't know if you heard me, I said it's pitch black in here.
Uh-huh.
This just started popping up with colors everywhere. Then a figure popped up right in front of me, standing right there.
Yeah.
So.
Well, let's.
We got to get back in there.
I really want to set up the static camera back there so we can actually see what's going on.
Whoever's back here, I just saw you. Please come up front and speak to us. All right, you can follow me. Come on. After reviewing our footage, we caught EVP from one of the static cameras. Can you tell what it's saying?
Right, can you follow me? Come on. Right, can you follow me?
Our next session is going to be the Estes method. This has become popular in the paranormal field. Each one of us will take turns and Allison will go first. She'll be using the SB Spirit Box tapped into soundproof headphones. Father Reuben will then ask questions and Allison will call out what the Spirit Box is telling her.
Do you need help?
It's a choice.
Oh, yeah.
Are you some other type of being?
Okay, I'm physically feeling a pain.
Who are you?
He's trying to jump me, whatever it is.
Were you conjured here? Will you show yourself to us tonight?
I'm coming.
Something's interfering with this.
I figured it would just go dead all of a sudden. And it's like, yeah, see, look.
You fail. Yeah.
During Allison's session, we started to have technical difficulties again, and this is what Father Reuben had to say about that.
And sometimes we run into things like this. It's not like, you know, everything's being rehearsed, but we're trying to get everything set up. And sometimes we'll run into problems, and sometimes entities will interfere with us again and again. It's happened before. And entities are very smart. I would have to say to all of you, never underestimate their intelligence. Whether it's a non-human entity or human entity. Sometimes.
This thing here.
Mm-hmm.
And then what?
The blindfold.
This is the blindfold? That looks like a bra. That looks like a training bra for like a 4-year-old. What is this thing? Look at this. They want me to put this on my face. What is this, Animal House? Who am I, John Belushi?
Who are you?
Pardon?
Who are you?
I'm here.
I know, but what's your name?
Things that get out.
Same thing.
Are you talking to me, Michelle, or Ben Get Out? Go touch Ben on his head.
Stop. Under something.
Go touch Ben.
You hurt children, don't you? Is that why you're refusing to leave, because you're afraid you won't get into heaven?
Get out. F you.
Ooh, you hit it.
Who are you? Who's messing with Michelle?
I'm getting chills.
you.
And like Ben said earlier, it's just, it's either nothing or it's going super, super fast.
That's what it was doing with me to begin, when I first began. Who's here?
Hi.
That's the same thing it did for you too.
Oh shit.
Come on. Oh shit. Okay. She's fine. She's fine.
The first three sessions were pretty interesting. To have Allison, Ben, and I all get either I'm coming or I'm here come through the SB7 is pretty amazing.
I'm coming.
I'm here.
Coming. I'm here.
Then in my session, when I got the chills,
get chills,
and I felt something come up from behind me.
Who's back here?
It's pretty cool that we caught that light anomaly come around me, and then something startled me because I felt something actually come up in front of me. Were we finally connecting with the spirit that everyone's been talking about?
Father Reuben is heading back.
Is it that way?
Yeah, I would go that way. Yeah, you gotta go that way.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Who am I? I'm gonna bless this place, and where it was not supposed to be, are gonna be gone. I know you're here. I will exorcise you if you are not human. I know you're behind me. I'm having gross interference. Michelle, Ben, Allison.
Okay.
Anybody else is listening. I'm having interference. It's not good. It's not happy. Michelle and Ben, someone wants to go to the light.
Okay. Somebody wants to go to the light. We will. You will send them to the light if they do. What, just now?
So tell me what you experienced, Father Reuben. Mm-hmm. You know, right before you said something's behind me, I saw something behind me.
I know.
They said they did too.
I saw it twice.
Yeah,
somebody on the chat said it.
And then I've seen something in front of me.
Yeah.
And the camera, it went out. And
the shadow behind him is huge. I saw a flash of light in the corner.
I was getting from all different directions at the same time. Yeah.
It didn't like what I was doing, so it showed manifest in front of me. The back in front of me. So this entity I got angry said for me to die.
Now, I was just back here in the dark looking because they said that you know, it crawls on the ceiling like it on the catwalk. It gets on the catwalk up here.
That's what I've been seeing,
and then it crouches on the heater, that thing, you know, when you first walk in down that door down there. And so
that's what I said. I can't.
And then it says it'll follow you as you walk.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing. That's what I noticed when I was up here. It was up here.
Yeah.
And that's what it was doing. Like, it was going from here, and then it jumped over here. I was sitting down.
Oh, when you were sitting down and you were...
It manifested through here or something, and it went back in and went into it. Then I see it again coming out like this, and then like halfway, and then go back in.
Yeah.
I don't know what it was doing.
It did give me a lot of F words.
Yeah.
And then it told me to die. Something didn't sound human, told me to die.
I was back over there. I'm worried to go in there. I feel like I'm going to lose the...
All right, we're coming back here.
Signal.
You told Father you're going to die. Shame on you.
Show yourself. This is your chance to tell us what you want or why you're here before Father Reuben casts you out. Call upon all the entities in this building to come forward, come to my voice. There you go. Yep, see him?
Mm-hmm.
All right, that's very brave of you to be right next to me. Are you trying to see yourself? Who else is with you? Oh, damn it. They do this to me every freaking time. Mm-hmm. All right, I'm going to reboot this, but listen. You can't come near my camera.
I had him right here, mm-hmm. and he...
You were getting something on the
yeah,
camera?
And he yeah. got too close to the camera.
Mm. Son of a bitch.
I'm trying to reboot this screen.
They're saying activities here at 1 and 2.
Yeah, that's where that...
But you know, the last time we were here, wasn't the activity like 6?
Yeah, 5
wasn't
and 6.
It? Yeah, we were getting like a lot of stuff at 5, because that's when we had the camera set up over
yeah.
there at 5 and
Get
6.
Get behind me so this doesn't bit you.
Well, I'm not on the... Oh, I see what you mean here.
Okay. Whoever we were talking to, can you please show yourself again, but just keep a distance from my camera.
What?
You really have to stay away from the camera. Go back over between lane 1 and 2.
Just a little bit.
And like I was telling you, this is your chance to let us know. Oh, damn it. All right, I'm done.
Well, let's go wrap up the...
I'm doing this.
Yeah, because I'm here. That's why they know I'm gonna kick them out.
No, but I had a big spike.
Yeah, that's what I mean. I'm here. That's where I'm...
Oh!
I'm fixing it.
Holy shit. Come here, Father Reuben.
Yeah.
Hey. Wait, you stay there because I don't want the
I want to see the spike on
know,
the meter.
I know, but I'm
going to
have it.
It's holy water.
What about your watch? What is
no,
your watch?
My watch is not liquid. It's just it's a wine
yeah.
mechanism.
Oh, it's just a winding,
it's
right?
a winding thing.
Yeah.
Look, when I get it's my phone is setting that off.
Yeah,
because look
yeah.
how close my phone is.
Yeah, but she was here. It was spiking. Well, her phone maybe. Yeah. Oh, holy water, not. It probably was interference. But.
Was it was exciting either way.
It's after 5 a.m. and it's time to wrap things up and let Father Reuben cleanse this building. Although I wasn't attacked during this visit, we did get some compelling evidence of the paranormal. The spirits were calling out Ben's name.
That's it, Ben.
I knew you were going to say that.
It did.
Oh!
It said it did. Did you hear that?
Father Reuben was sensing spirits throughout the night.
Like I said, I keep seeing something manifest over there. Keep going in and out, in and out.
They're in the center of me. This is the center. And that's what I'm feeling right now. Something behind me.
We caught this strange light anomaly on lane 11. The spirits were definitely affecting the equipment throughout the night.
Sometimes entities will interfere with us again and again. It's happened before. In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hopefully, any lost souls were able to go to the light with Father Reuben's prayers. Casting out unclean spirits is not an easy job.
Leave now. Go now. Do not return. If you are who you are, be gone. You're not longer welcome. Get out now. In the name of Jesus Christ!
Mystic Ghost. Subscribe and scratch on notifications if you dare.